Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do after saying hi is we're gonna prime our face, and I'm gonna use my favorite primer of all time, which is the Laura Mercier Foundation Primer in Radiance. I've used this so many times on my channel before, and I've honestly gone through 5 bottles of this my whole life, so if that doesn't tell you how much I love it, I don't know what will. Then I'm using the Makeup Forever HD stick because I really want my skin to look very flawless and like perfect, because her skin looks like so airbrushed and like perfect, which she is, so you know, trying to be like Taylor Swift. And I'm gonna blend that out with a beauty blender, and we're just gonna blend this out into perfection and really make sure it melts into the skin. Then I'm gonna use the Kevin Aucoin Sensual Skin Enhancer in the lightest shade for myself, because I have very light skin, and I'm basically gonna use it to really cover up my darkness. And then in addition to that, I'm gonna be using the Tarte Creaseless Concealer, which is actually a new product, but is actually an older product, just repackaged. And yeah, I really love this concealer so much. It used to be my favorite concealer of all time. And after blending that out, I'm gonna use the Anastasia Cream Contour Kit. And the reason I'm doing this is because Taylor's skin looks very much contoured, but like, still very lifelike and perfect, and I really just want it to look like skin, so that's what I'm basically doing with the creams. Then I'm going to use this very, 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 very tiny jar of Laura Mercier translucent powder, and honestly, this was such a fail because it is so tiny, you can barely get anything out of it, and I'm struggling, like hardcore struggling. So I'm going to be using my favorite powder, which is the NARS translucent crystal lighting powder. This is my go-to powder of all time. I've literally gone through this like water, and I love this stuff so much, I highly recommend it. Then I'm gonna be using the Sleek Contour Kit in Fair, and I'm gonna be using the bronze shade to bronze up the face. So because Taylor is on a red carpet in the beginning of the music video, I'm really making sure my skin looks bronzed, because most likely you're gonna be bronzed on a red carpet because of flashing lights, and it is a music video, so she's gonna be heavily bronzed. But of course we're gonna really blend that out. I'm using a very big A Cosmetics brush to blend it all out and really make it look like the skin. Then I'm gonna use this contour blush. It's technically a blush, but it's really a contour. And I think they discontinued this, so it breaks my heart. But this is Tranquil blush, it's not a blush. And I'm gonna be using that to contour because I don't have the hollows of the cheeks like Taylor does. I have a very round face. She has more of a heart-shaped face, so I'm really just contouring to my own need, but you know. Then I'm gonna be using this blush. Technically, it's not necessarily a blush, but I actually do use it as a somewhat of a blush for the bronzer. It doesn't make sense, but it makes sense for this look because she doesn't really have that much blush on, and this is Baby Don't Go by MAC. And then I'm gonna use a highlighter in that Sleek palette, which I feel is a perfect highlighter because her skin is definitely glowing, but it's not overly like blinding. And so I really wanted to make it look very natural, but also glowy, if that makes sense. Then I'm kind of using Studio Fix powder to kind of make my skin look more airbrushed and more like perfect, because that's what her skin looks like. And then I'm further highlighting the tip of the nose, which you can definitely see in the music video is accentuated. Then I'm gonna be adding a little bit of blush, but I'm using a very, very natural blush for this, which is Exposed by Tarte. I'm really using this just to add a bit of color, nothing too much, because I definitely think that they would add blush for the music video. Then I'm just gonna fill in my brows, nothing too crazy. I just fill in my brows normally. I'm not really following her brow shape at all because I have very different brows compared to Taylor, but you know, do whatever makes you happy. I'm just filling my brows away. I'd like them to be filled, and I'm using the Brow Wiz by Anastasia. Then I'm going to prime my lids with the 24 Hour Prep and Prime eyeshadow base by MAC. I really like this stuff. And yeah, I mean, I don't really have too much to say about it. It's a really good eye primer. I feel like it makes everything stick and it's very good. I think, you know, it makes eyeshadows last like they should. Then I'm going to set that with the translucent powder from NARS because God knows nothing comes out of that Laura Mercier one. And I'm going to be using the Lorac Pro palette, the original one. And I'm using this mainly because I really think that this palette works really well for this look. I use a couple other shadows, but I really think that this palette works for it, and you can definitely just use this palette alone. So I'm using the shade Taupe in the palette really to define the crease because her look is very simple, but she does have a very defined crease, so I'm just making sure that I have that cool neutral shade that will be perfect for this eye look. And of course, we're going to blend out that shade because we don't want any harsh lines or anything. We really want this to look seamless and effortless at the same time. So we're going to blend this out with the Morphe E27 brush. Any blending brush will work fine. And then we're going to use the shade Mauve from the Lorac palette. And this is a great shade because it adds a little bit more coolness into the eye look. And then after, we're going to use the shade Sable, which is a really great definer shade, and we're just going to use that on the outer corner. And then we're going to basically just blend that out and make sure that everything looks very seamless. And then we're going to use a beige vanilla shade to just blend out the brow bone, just to make sure everything's cleaned and perfect. After that, I'm going to be using two shades from MAC, and these are Malt and Kid. They are very neutral shades, and the reason why I picked them is because I felt like this look was pulling a little too cool, in my opinion. So I really wanted to make sure that it kept its neutral tone, and I'm using that under the eye as well, on the lower lash line. Then I'm going in to Shroom by MAC, which is one of my favorite shades from MAC of all time. I'm also going to wet it to just give it a little bit more oomph. Her eyes are very much shimmery, but not overly glittery. It looks like a very natural sheen. So I knew that Shroom would be the perfect shade for it. And then I'm gonna go into my favorite eyeliner. Don't drop it like I did. And it is Mambo by NARS. This eyeliner is so creamy, but it's a pencil eyeliner. It's not like the gel eyeliner. How it's creamy like this, I have no idea. It's witchcraft to me, but honestly, it's so gorgeous. And I love the way it looks on the eyes. Very much like Costa Rica by MAC, and I personally think it's a lot better. And then I'm gonna tight line the eyes with the Tartiest Tarte eyeliner. This eyeliner is jet black, and if you need a jet black eyeliner, get this eyeliner. And then I'm gonna do it off camera and also line my top lash line, basically just dabbing it like lightly on the eye to create a perfect line, then using that Mambo eyeliner on top again. Just to give that dimension, I do see that she has a warm tone eyeliner on top. And because I'm really bad at doing my false lashes, I did it off camera because it took forever. And I'm using my favorite false lashes, which is Wispy Sweet Nothing by Velour. So for the lips, I'm going in with a NARS lip liner. I forgot what shade name it is. I'll put it in the description down below. Her lip color is very interesting because it pulls more purple in the beginning part of the video, but then pulls more red after she dances in the ring. So because of this, I first used Olivia as a base from NARS, and then I put Vera on top so that after it washes away, I will still have that red lip if I dance in the rain. I probably won't dance in the rain, but you know, you never know these days. Anyways, that is a completed look. I hope you guys really, really enjoyed it. I enjoyed making it, and I'm glad to be back. I hope you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and if you do recreate this look, please remember to tag me in any of the pictures that you post online.
Jeans and your Nikes, look at you. Oh, damn. Oh my god, my eyelashes. Is it cool that I said all that? Is it too soon to do this yet?